of you. All the dignitaries on the dais. The sheet anchor for today's program and the inspiration for all of us, Mr. Akshit Tandon, cyber security expert, my colleagues, Shikha Goyal, additional CP crime, D.S. Chauhan, additional CP law and order, Avinash Mohanty, joint CP CCS DD, Vishnu Prasad, joint CP Central Zone, Narmada, Raghubir, all my colleagues, and most important, the future leaders of India. First of all, I would compliment all of you, and I am encouraged by this presence of 102 students, out of which 74 are girls. So this is India now. This is India now, and that is why I always say that the present generation of students, all of you are really lucky, because you are growing up in an atmosphere, in a situation when things are really happening. And I would like to mention in brief about how you people are so lucky. For the sake of understanding, many people divide the entire growth of human civilization into four phases. The first phase, when the entire humankind were food gatherer, they were gathering food, and it continued for almost 1,000 years. Then they became food producer. Again, it continued for thousands and more years. Then agriculture became refined with use of technology. And what was the first use of technology then? It was the use of iron. So it took almost 4,000 years for human being to come to the level of producing agricultural produce with the help of technology. And all those countries, all those nations became great which used that technology early. In India, it almost started in 6th century before Christ, when what is called the second phase of urbanization started. And that was the time when, if we go by the books of Western scholars who visited India, one of the most famous traveler was Megasthenes, a Greek traveler who visited India and wrote the book Indica. And in that, he has mentioned about the cities of India that time, which was much more modern developed than London, Rome and other places. It was only because we were ahead in technology then. Subsequently, because of various reasons, we declined and others went ahead. Others went ahead much faster when the Industrial Revolution started in the 14th, 15th century. And then France, England, Germany, they all became industrialized, and India became poor and poor and poor and poor because we lagged behind in technology. Then, you know, we were not master of our own destiny. Britishers were ruling, and then when they left, we were one of the poorest countries in the world. You must have heard the famous speech, Oxford Union speech of Mr. Shashi Tharoor, in which he has mentioned that from 27% of the world GDP, when the Britishers came at the shore of India. From 27% of the world GDP, when they left, we were less than 2%. It's all because when England was industrializing itself, India was de-industrializing itself. So that is the role of technology. From 27%, we came down to 2%. And it took almost 50, 60 years of hard work for us now to claim that we are standing on our feet. So imagine how the nation has struggled over the entire 5,000 years. I have tried to sum up in 2 minutes. And why I am saying all these things? Because it is only the next generation, people like you, who carry the flag of development, of innovation, of technology, higher and higher compared to the previous generation. You have to be smarter than us. You have to be more knowledgeable than us. You have to be more tech-savvy than us. Then only the country will grow. I always mention, friends, that earlier competition, the first competition starts between siblings, brothers and sisters, brothers and brothers, sisters and sisters. That's the first competition in life. Then the competition goes into the classroom when you compete with among your own students. Then if you are excellent in certain things like sports, quiz and all, then the competition goes into one college, into another college. Then even grow university versus university, city versus city. But now you are competing with each and every student of New York, London, Paris, Tokyo, all because of technology. The graduate management aptitude test, GMAT, which is taken by lakhs and lakhs of students every week. It's a platform which puts you on equal footing with each and every student on the earth. That is the technology, the GRE, all the exams. So in this background, can you and I afford to remain backward? No. We have to remain ahead of everything. And now, things are changing so fast that how to manage change is the most important thing. In fact, 20, 25 years back, perhaps 35 years back, there is a famous book written by Alvin Toffler, Future Shock. If it is available on internet, you can read it. And it says that the biggest challenge now for the present generation will be how to manage the fast changing world. The future is changing so fast that if you are not equipping yourself, you will be in for a shock. It is as simple as that. If a person who is living in a village in Etunagram, in Warangal district, and suddenly from there he's taken up and put up it at a Microsoft office in Gachibowli, how will he find himself? He will be shocked because he does not know so many things. A person who is just riding cycle, and if he is taken and put it on an auto-driving car of Tesla, what will he do? He will be shocked because he doesn't know things. That is why if you and I are not equipping ourselves with the latest knowledge of technology, we will be shocked by various things. And now things are changing so fast that every 3 months, 6 months, or maximum 1 year, the computing power of a computing device is getting doubled. Is it not?
Yes.
So imagine when the computing device is multiplying with a rate of doubling its speed maximum in 1 year, you also have to double your speed. Otherwise, you will lag behind. You will absolutely lag behind. Merely hard work is not enough. Hard work to the level that you have to compete with others, that is required. Running at the speed at which others are running is required. And that is why this is one of the small initiatives from Hyderabad City Police to enlighten you, to make you partners in our effort. And I'm thankful that Mr. Tanda and Mr. Kohli, our partners and all our senior officers here, we have taken this initiative. And I appeal to all the media and the press that this is a role which they have to take on their shoulder of creating awareness. Because this hall is maximum, it will take 200 people. We have taken 100 people, 100 students. That is not enough. That is not at all enough. A city of 1 crore above population, it requires at least 25 lakh people to know all these things. How it is possible? If there is no support, if there is no encouragement from media, it will not happen. That is why role of media, role of print media is very, very important, and I appeal to all the media brothers here to kindly carry it forward. Now, about police, that why police is doing this. I would like to draw your attention to a great man who is called the father of modern police. During free time, you can read about him. Sir Robert Peel. Robert Peel was a bureaucrat in United Kingdom, UK, in 1840-1850. He subsequently became the Prime Minister also. Twice he was the Prime Minister. And since he came from the citizens' background, community service, so he knew a lot about what community expects from police. And there are so many things he has written. But one thing which I want to mention here is the foundation of modern police. He said that the most important principle of policing is that we all should know that every citizen is a policeman and every police person is a citizen. That is the foundation of his entire philosophy. And that is why I always give this example, and I will repeat that example here. At the National Police Academy, there is a statue, an uncut, unchiseled statue, and underneath there is a quotation of Michelangelo, the famous sculptor. Somebody asked Michelangelo, how do you produce a beautiful statue out of this barren rock? And he said, there is a beautiful statue inside every rock. I just give little chisel and little shape here and there. And that is why the police academy does the same thing. When we go to there for training, we go as a civilian, as a student. But within few months, we come out from there as a police officer. Now that is the same logic, that there is a police man or a police woman inside every student, each one of you. You have to just make it alert, make it cautious. Make it aware. There is a police person in each one of you, and similarly, there is a citizen in each one of us. We are first citizen and then policeman. So when this kind of bondage is there between citizen and police, whatever police does, whatever police thinks, whatever police expects from society, we have to share with you. And who can be a better partners than the young, upcoming, bright student like you. And that is why we have chosen that this is a first small step in the long journey, and you will be the brand ambassadors for entire initiative which all of us are taking to make you aware, so that you in turn make at least 100 students aware each. So 100 into 100 it should be. That is the objective. So with these things, I would not like to take much of your time, and this is a very beautiful opportunity. Know about us, show your curiosity, learn maximum things. We have one of the experts here in the form of Mr. Tandon, and he would tell you about so many initiatives, so many things which are happening here, and I'm really grateful to all the officers who have come here, and particularly Mr. Kohli, who has been our partners, who have always encouraged Hyderabad City Police to take up good cause for the sake of society. Thank you so much. Jai.